Turn the microphone over to my dear friend, Mike Lavery. And I just want to add, after each of us speaks, we're going to have a very, I would think, contentious conversation, because a lot of us disagree on a lot of things.
Okay, well, let's just hear Mike.
There you go, Mike.
Well, at least to me, 1969 through 1970 was just a continuation of the years before. I spent essentially a year stumbling through it. I had, during the whole decade, belonged to my whole list of alphabet organizations, SPU, Student Peace Union, SANE, FOR, Fellowship of Reconciliation, CNVA, WRL, War Resisters League, all this. I also, when 69 came in Stonewall, not particularly unknown to gay organizations, I had joined by mail an organization called One in 1962, having lied about my age because you were supposed to be 21 and I was only 20 at the time. When I came to New York, I sort of investigated what I could find in regard to gay organizations. The only organization I could find was the West Side Discussion Group. My boyfriend and I went to a meeting. It was sort of in a dingy sort of loft somewhere in the 30s of men that seemed to be at least twice our age. So we never went back. We were in California. I was there on business and taking a vacation in June of 69. We had gone to the People's Park to participate in a protest because People's Park had recently been shut down, and trying to escape from being hit by the water or fire hose, I had ducked into a corner, and to occupy the time, I bought a Berkeley Barb, which said homosexuals were rioting in New York. On returning a couple days later, I went to what I believe was one of the first demonstrations in front of the Women's House of Detention on Greenwich Avenue. Someone came up to me, and it was probably Marty Robinson, who suggested there was a group forming, a group of younger people at Mattachine called the Mattachine Action League. So we went to that. Mattachine didn't seem to like us very much and didn't seem to be doing too much. So ultimately, I came to GLF, somewhat after the first dance. But I spent, again, most of that year trying to decide, where things should go. There seemed to be a lot of people, at least at the time to me, that they had some sort of plan. Never exactly figure out what that plan was, but they did seem to have a plan. And 69, I didn't particularly like people with plans, particularly if they were trying to push you into their plan. So then, in many ways, I spent the year stumbling around, stumbling in terms of self-discovery, learning things about myself, learning things to try to make the pathways between working at that time, I worked for a legal publisher, as I had tried to find all these pathways before when I was a student in law school, at the same time being called before the university's committee because I belonged to and was vice president of something called the Student Peace Union, and that we had given our meeting space to a group to try to get members, something called Students for a Democratic Society. And they weren't exactly sure who this SDS people were. And they weren't sure about me, and they weren't sure why I appeared on TV with a friend of mine who was later written up in Esquire's summer edition, How You Spent Your Summer. And he was the star of it because it said, well, various people did this, they did that, but Tommy Rodd went to jail. He went to jail because this was the 60s and he decided to tear up his draft card rather than all that. But I still, trying to balance many times GLF had meetings, protests, demonstrations. I was not there because I worked at a job that began at 9 and ended at 5. I have my weekends, have my evenings, but during the day, I was an assistant technical advisor to Times Mirror and to a law book publisher. But again, what happened during those years, the result of what happened before, is certainly affected me afterwards. I have been involved in a few things, particularly in the legal area. I'm one of the founders of Lambda Legal Defense and Education Fund. All of this results from my time at GLF and ultimately with GAA. I had been asked sometime, I think it was November of 69, after we had gone to one of the peace organization rallies in DC to join what I had laughingly called at that time the Jim and Marty organization. They had told me, and I was good friends, I think quite good friends with Jim and with Marty Robinson, Jim Miles, and they had decided they were going to have a meeting to discuss their viewpoint of what should be going on. I felt that I really owed it to GLF to continue with them. So I decided not to go and not become a part of it. Ultimately, it turned out it was the organizational meeting for the founding of GAA. But that was in line with what I had just said. There were people who had plans, and I was, you know, they had that agenda. We always talked about who has an agenda.
Yes.
Be afraid of someone with an agenda.
Yeah,
well,
right.
Almost everyone had an agenda. I mean, even I had an agenda of not having an agenda. I mean, it's part of that sort of spirit of the times. You know, the thing that you really somewhat wanted was that journey to the end of meetings. When would all these meetings end? But somehow or other, we meet and meet and we. I spent every night of the week. When I started, I lived on the Upper East Side. Ultimately, I moved to the Village because I was spending every night in the Village, commuting back and forth between there and the Upper East Side. It's an important time in my life. It's important for me. It's important to ultimately determine, I think, who I became. I think it's also a time of disappointment. It's a time that could be. Part of my attraction to GLF was, in fact, the promises that we could become. I don't think we've actually fulfilled a lot of those. But then I'm the one who thought, gee, here it is, 69, 60, you know, we have law students smoking grass, you know, soon we'll have, you know, Supreme Court judges who aren't going to be, you know, be so uptight as, you know, the ones that they were because, gee, you know, back in their youth, they were toting a joint. Well, that didn't happen. And the radicalization didn't happen. But I think a lot of good things do. So maybe I can discuss more of it when we talk, but I think I'll end what at least I'm saying is a little early. I should keep in mind, quoting, I think it's Joseph Lucy, the past is a foreign country. They do things differently there. And they really, really do. That's what I'll
Thank you, Mike.